Avantika, how are you?
I'm very fine. How are you?
Very well.
Okay. I've been a big fan of yours since Magadira because you always managed to look like a fairy tale princess.
How sweet. Thank you.
You're welcome.
You're also looking like a princess right now.
Thank you.
And throughout this movie, you're looking so adorable.
Thank you. My favorite hero is Mahesh Babu, obviously because he looks so good and everything.
I think everyone's favorite.
Yeah, everyone's favorite. So, who was your favorite hero as when you were a kid?
When I was a kid? Oh, Aamir Khan.
Aamir Khan.
Still is. I still love Aamir Khan.
How was your childhood like? I mean, it's different from children right now. So, how was your childhood like? What did you do as a kid?
I was a brat. I was a menace for my mother. Oh God, I really feel so sorry for her. And I hope I don't have kids like me. I hope I have well-behaved kids. But well, my parents were disciplinarians, but they were also very loving and very friendly.
Okay. So
my sister and me have grown up in a very nice, happy, homely environment with a lot of cousins, with a lot of family around us. Mm-hmm. And we are very blessed to have a really big family.
Okay.
And majority of my family lives very close by. So we've done a lot of holidays together, we've always been together for occasions, we've always, celebrated things together, like birthdays or anniversaries or any occasion. Something as simple as me getting an award in school was celebrated by the whole family.
Okay.
My aunts and my uncles and my cousins. So it was one big family,
Okay. Which
is kind of very similar to our film.
Our film, yeah.
Because the entire concept of the film is about a huge family and about celebration of life. And my family and my atmosphere has been exactly the same.
Okay, that's nice. You have a nice family.
I could really relate to this entire film.
Yeah. This is your second time with Mahesh Babu, right?
Mm-hmm.
After a businessman.
Yeah.
So how was the experience after working with him after 4 years?
It was really nice. Mahesh is still the same.
Yeah.
He's a lot of fun to work with. He's extremely professional. And of course, when you work with somebody for the first time and then you're working with the same person again, you build a certain kind of rapport. You understand each other's timing. It just becomes easier. You know the person. You know the person. I mean, you've worked with the person before. You know the person's body language. You know how the person's going. You can almost preempt how the person's going to react. So, of course, it was very comfortable, which is very evident on screen.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a really nice time working with Mahesh. And I just feel with every film, far better than what he was in his previous film. And he was really good to begin with. So he just improves a lot more with every film of his and is like mastering his craft.
Describe to me a little bit about your role in Brahmotsavam. Is it relatable to your real life?
It actually is. So I play a girl named Kasi.
Okay.
And she is somebody who's very independent, very strong-headed, confident, individualistic, and she's a go-getter. She's very ambitious and she follows her dreams. And she also is a girl with a lot of priorities and she knows her priorities. So she has a mind and she knows her mind.
Okay.
And yes, I could relate to the role a lot because I am exactly like that in reality. And at the same time, she's very grounded, homely, humble, curious. She's an adventure seeker. So I am like that.
Yeah.
Quite a bit.
Yeah. What was your most emotional experience in Brahmotsavam?
Well, so I have this scene with Mahesh, which is a very crucial scene for my character.
Okay.
And it's a bit of a dilemma. The scene is a dilemma where she really, really wants something, but at the same time, her ambitions are just different.
Okay.
And her priorities are different.
Yeah.
So she's caught in this rigmarole of emotions and she does not know what to choose. But well, she decides and she makes up her mind and she chooses.
Yeah.
But it's difficult to make that choice. But she has to do it. So well, that scene is complicated and emotional. And also very real. When you grow up, you'll understand.
Still now also we have a lot of dilemmas. Throughout our life, we also have
baby,
dilemmas.
When you grow up, yeah. You'll understand what I'm talking about.
Yeah. This is your first time working with Srikanta Dalagar,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Did you like the way he portrayed you in the movie?
Very much. Extremely. I had a lovely time working with Srikanta Dalagaru. He is a very simple person. But at the same time, he is so clear. And he's just so real. I mean, it was fantastic knowing him as a person. He's a very down-to-earth, very simple person. He is happy with a few things. And he just requires those few things to make him happy. That's all he wants.
Yeah.
And I love that innocence that he has. And his innocence translates onto his films and onto the big screen as well. And even this film has real emotions. he has projected very raw reality in such a beautiful manner. And in the beginning, I was a little hesitant about my character because I had never done something so strong before. So I wasn't sure about the portrayal of the character. But Srikanth Garu has superseded my expectations. And he's made me so comfortable through it. I've learned a lot from the film and from him.
You've done shooting in multiple locations. What's your favorite location?
So, well, the film has been shot in multiple locations, but I shot primarily in Hyderabad and a lot in Ooty.
Okay.
And Ooty, of course, the weather was great. It was really cold. We were so many of us, so it was a big picnic. And Ooty was fun.
I've always seen your costumes are so nice. How do you manage to get them so well designed every time?
Thank you. That's really sweet of you. And it's a very girly thing. I mean, only girls would get this, right?
Yeah.
High five. Yeah, my costumes. Well, my stylist, Archa, she has worked with me on a couple of films. She has worked extremely hard on the film. And we wanted to portray that beautiful combination, that amalgamation of innocence, but at the same time, independence. And I play an NRI girl, so she comes from abroad. But at the same time, you know, NRI girls are usually portrayed on screen as very rebellious. I don't understand why. I mean, they're normal girls, right? So we've maintained that. Like, we are showing them as very normal girls. And normal family girls who like to wear normal clothes. I mean, I'm not this punky, rebellious chick. There's no need for that. So I play a normal girl and I'm wearing normal clothes. And that's the way we've projected it.
When you were a child and still now, who is your inspiration as an actor or an actress?
So there's this French actress called Audrey Tautou.
Okay.
I love her. She's gorgeous. She acts so naturally. And she's so spontaneous and impromptu. I love that about her.
Okay.
Nicole Kidman.
Okay.
I think she's great. She's done some fabulous work. Angelina Jolie. Many people, yeah. Many people. Cameron Diaz for her spunk and her spontaneity.
Yeah.
So many people.
So you're a big inspiration yourself. So
you.
What advice would you give to young and aspiring actors?
Well, I'd like to tell all the young and aspiring actors out there, believe in your dreams, follow your conviction, follow your heart, and work extremely hard. There is absolutely no substitute for hard work. And please finish your education and then think of venturing into any industry that you want to.
We're going to do a small rapid fire right now. Okay, so let's start.
Shoot.
What's your favorite cartoon?
Simpson, Family Guy, South Park. Well, those are not really cartoons. Those are more like TV shows.
Yeah.
But Flintstones. I used to love Flintstones. I used to love Jetsons. Scooby-Doo.
If you could choose a princess you wanted to be, which princess would you choose?
In today's day and age, Ella from Frozen. Every girl wants to be her, right?
Yeah. What's your favorite animated movie?
Favorite animated movie? The Little Mermaid.
Okay. Which chocolate do you hate the most?
I love chocolate. It's so hard. Which chocolate do I hate? Five Star.
Five Star?
I've got nothing against you guys, but yeah, I don't like Five Star.
If you had to leave home with only one makeup item, which makeup item would that be?
A creme blush, so that I can wear that on my cheeks and my lips as well. I can just tint my lips and my cheeks together.
Okay. So what's your dream destination?
The Caribbean Islands, Bahamas, Barbados, not been there yet.
Tell to me a childhood dress you wished you could wear now, but obviously you can't.
A tutu skirt. Now I look mad.
So, heels or flats?
Flats, any day, right here.
So what's your best outfit in your wardrobe?
I think a little black dress goes for any occasion and you can dress it up or dress it down. I mostly dress it up. That's like a classic. So I have this gorgeous, gorgeous Valentino little black dress.
Iced tea or hot chocolate?
Hot chocolate. Without a doubt. What about you?
Hot chocolate.
Okay, wait. I'm not supposed to ask you. You're supposed to ask me.
Yes.
That's how it works. Right.
What's your usual bedtime?
10? 10 p.m. I'm early to bed, early to rise.
Morning person or night person?
Night person. Strangely, because I usually sleep early and I need to sleep early. I need my sleep. So I'm very obsessed about my sleep. And in the morning, I'm very grumpy, strangely. Except for when I'm waking up to work out. Then I'm very happy.
Oh, you're happy when you want to work out.
I'm exercising, I'm very happy.
Are you a lazy person?
No.
You're not lazy.
I need to do something all the time.
Are you a foodie?
Total.
What's your favorite food?
Southeast Asian. So So Thai, Japanese, Vietnamese, Korean.
Do you sing in the shower?
No, I sing outside the shower.
What's a talent other than acting?
Cooking.
You cook?
Uh-huh.
What do you cook?
I cook the kind of food that I like to eat, so healthy variations of anything. Okay. Especially baking, like I love baking. That's because I have a massive sweet tooth. So I bake healthier versions.
What's your favorite color?
It depends on my mood, honestly. I don't have one favorite. It totally depends on what I'm feeling for the day.
Like those mood necklaces which tell you which mood according to that color?
I've heard of those mood necklaces but never worn them. But that's the way it is for me for color. I usually have a black day or a brown day or a white day, things like that.
So if you had to change your hair color, which hair color would you choose?
Purple.
I swear, like seriously, I'm dying to color my hair purple, but then my directors will just kill me or something.
What's your favorite animal?
Horses.
What's
and dolphins.
And dolphins, same here. What's your favorite bear? Like there's a lot of types of bears, right?
Winnie the Pooh?
Winnie the Pooh.
Or maybe, who's the bear from the Jungle Book? What's his name? I'm forgetting.
Babu.
Balu, not Babu. He's Balu.
Yeah, Balu.
The Jungle Book.
Yeah, in Jungle Book. So would you wear a t-shirt and jeans or would you wear a skirt and a frilly top?
Depends on where I'm going, but mostly t-shirt and jeans.
Yeah, I can see. So that's the end of the rapid fire. Good luck with Brahmotsavam.
Thank you and same to you. Is this your first film?
Yes, this is my first.
Are you excited?
Yes, I'm very excited.
Are you nervous?
I'm also nervous to see how will I look.
You?
I'm 11.
Oh. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. And so guys, we're releasing on the 20th of May. Go watch the film.
Only in theatres.
Exactly.